Well, what features of Microsoft Teams are very useful for teaching effectively? I'll talk about these features, some of these features, 7 features. The first one is that have a safe distance, reasonable distance from camera, yeah. You should have 1 to 2 feet distance at least from the camera. That will give you a good posture of you, that will not show your face magnified and your eyes and nose a big one. Okay, this is the first tip. Second is that you should manage the team. Once you are here, Teams, go to manage. When you go to manage, you see here you have members and guests. You can assign a tag to all these. You can assign a tag to all these. When you will assign a tag to all of these, then when you'll go to general and post, whatever you'll post here at the rate of tag, all those who are tagged with AE, they will get this message. You see 3 people have this tag, so all these 3 people will get this message instead of sending these messages or posts individually. So in manage teams, go to tags, assign tags. For example, when I do other meetings, I can assign a tag to some senior officials and other ones. Here you have an option to mute all the students. So you can mute all the students. They will keep on unmuting themselves. You can mute them. This option is available at some other place as well. So now you see general, you will have here start meeting. So you can meet now. And second tip is assign tags and at the same time go for participants. You see here you have option of managing teams. Don't allow everyone to share screen, because if you'll allow everyone to share the screen, what will happen that students will keep on interrupting. They will mute you, they will unmute others, and you will have a very difficult time. It will become difficult to manage the class. So save only me. That will take time and you will have this one. This is second tip, that you should assign tags and you should manage team in a way that you should have the right to present. Others don't have the right until and unless you specify. You can specify specific people as well. Then keep your background blur. You see here background, you can see a mirror and a fan going on. So you will keep on looking those things. If you have a very good scenery behind me, your attention may go to the may go there. So instead of use this blur background or some other nice background, now you will see a blur background that will have privacy for me, as well as it will not seek your attention. You can apply it, you can cross it, and this is one. Another feature which is available here, you might not have this at the moment, or you may have this one, raise your hand. So you see, when here student who want to ask a question will click here, raise hand. Okay, raise hand, lower hand, raise your hand, lower your hand. So this is how you can do that. You can ask the student who has raised her hand. you can use this feature. You can share the screen. You have different screens. You can share those screens. You have whiteboard here. You can share the whiteboard where you can write something if it is a touchable, or you have pin mobile. You can use the mobile pin pen. what other things I can share with you. Okay, another thing here, go to Teams. You will have here files. You can upload the files, but try to upload these files in a read-only format so that the students cannot edit it. You can have files here as well if you are using OneDrive. So my files are lying here. So you can say, you can see all these files I can use for my class from OneDrive instead of uploading it from the system. So you can use these files from here. What else? You can go to assignments. You can schedule a meeting. Or you can schedule a meeting. You can see a new meeting here. You can have a new meeting here. You can assign its title. You can give a time, everything. And here you will a meeting tag, and you can link it, copy it, and send this link. Schedule assistant, when you want to do this, who should attend it, what are optional attendees, and all this. Any other tip? Let's go to Teams, and I see what other thing I can discuss with you. You can share here quiz. Quiz will be in form. So you have forms here. You can create a form. These forms you can use here. For example, if I type here forms.office.com, so you see you can create a quiz here. New quiz. It's so simple to create here. You see what is the interest rate today in Pakistan. Today in Pakistan, you can add here choice, correct option 8%, 7, 9, 10. If I assign this one as correct option, correct answer, for this one I say it's incorrect. So if someone will click here, he or she will get a message incorrect. So this is incorrect. You can write, you can add a comment, incorrect. And you can share this form by copying link. But before that, go to settings. What are those settings? You can have one person, one response per person. You should have, you see, some colleagues sending messages. You see here settings, start date, so you can have a start date, you can have an end date, and you can adjust it as per your requirement. Send an email to recipient to respondents, receipt to respondents, to show that their quiz is submitted. So you can share this, copy this, go to Teams, go under posts. You can share here from existing, or you can go to posts here, control V. So you have shared field, you have shared the quiz, and now students will click here. They will submit their response. Because you have set the date such that this will start after 2 or 3 hours. So this is not accepting at the moment. So you can have open time, you can have closing time, and within that. You can also shuffle this. You can shuffle the questions as well, but here we have only one question, so we cannot shuffle it. So you can use this quiz here as well. And one more thing, very important one, that how you can engage students in the class. Now, for example, if I am creating this quiz and I ask some of you, okay, please let me know what was the question which I have created in the quiz. Those who were watching the video, who were listening me, they will let me know what I have asked. If they have left the room by muting their mics and switching off their cameras, so they will not be able to respond, and I can grade them accordingly. This will not only be interactive, as well as I will keep my students engaged. So these are a couple of tips: managing team, sharing screens, creating quiz online, and tagging the students and muting the students, and raising your hand and asking the question turn by turn. These are the things which you can use for Microsoft Teams for an effective teaching and effective learning. Thank you for watching.